grumbling about something troubling him deep down. He'd hang his head reflecting on each row, pointing a porch day in and day out, thinking about how he drowned his sorrow so it didn't surface. Religiously submerged his sins in bottle worship, how he'd hollowed his wallet just to pay the price and in turn purchased early access afterlife, but now eternally cursed.
No spirit could lift his low spirits now.
Even in leaving behind his wife, teen Dora, and her child one evening while he'd previously been seeing his demons away, feeling disgraced, pained, and angered, his standard answer and alcohol remained the same. But the ball and chain restraining weight of guilt haunted him, ever present, always sore and taunting him. Its morning routine of routine morning torment and grief tortured him, becoming the norm. Tragic scorn for it all had him trapped in torn sadness, driven up the wall by the pure madness, caught in a loop, always forcefully torn through his flaws, labyrinth and remorse, whose minotaur, this candid daily trail of thought and phantom, figment, distant memory mixed up with others to cover up his existence, as like an unmarked grave in their minds, he was dead to them, ringing the bells the day he died. A decision's ripples. With his back against the wall, slumped in front of a porch, replaying the days he turned his back on a moor, who he saw walking towards him, dawdling, distraught and exhausted, only reinforced his guilt. The poor kid walked with a morbid grin, head tilted forward, rake per will, an awkward sort of thing in his posture, feeling it was all his fault. That'll do.